Good morning, everyone. This is Stephanie with you from, well, not from St. Martin, but on behalf of St. Martin from my home on this Friday, May 22nd, 2020. And not much has changed week to week. We're still on quite a bit of a lockdown here in Michigan, but now we add to that a flood in our local areas, and it's kind of crazy. Hi, Alicia. Good to see you. So today, I realized last week, I think I did like a 20 or 24 minute time with you. We sang three songs, and we had a lot of fun. But I'll try to keep it a little shorter for those of you who have many things to do and places to go with masks on. And so what I wanted to read today is from Psalm 46, verse 1. And I'm just going to wait a little bit, see if a couple more people can jump on. And then I just have two hymns. I don't have three. But I know some people were requesting some of these hymns, and one is Thy Word, and I know a lot of our St. Martin people like that. They always sing real nice in church. And hi, Jody. Hi, Natalie. And so I was just saying what two songs we're gonna do, because I did three last week and we went a little long. So we're gonna do Thy Word is a lamp to my feet and a light unto my path. And we're also doing Rock of Ages, Cleft for Me. And that's a good one. So a lot of people like that one. I guess last time I did I'm But a Stranger Here, Heaven is My Home, and apparently I've done it like three times, somebody said, on these Fridays when we sing together. So I'm gonna try to make sure that I don't do that. Just a reminder, for those of you that are now tuned in, that we have online. I put the kids bulletin and also the worship service for Sunday. I think I have Wednesdays up still. So I think when I head down there today, Lori will give me the one for Sunday, and we'll get the Sunday one up for everybody too. You can print out your bulletin in advance. You can print out your kids bulletin in advance, and we'll go from there. So, this Friday devotion starts with, pardon me while I adjust my papers here. This Friday, hi Marilyn. This Friday devotion starts with Psalm 46, God is our refuge and strength. Hi Heather. And what I'm going to do when I read this, I really want you to listen to the words. When I printed it, I knew I wanted to do it because of everything that's going on. Not just our coronavirus and our lockdown, but, you know, the recent flooding in Michigan. So when you hear it, you'll just think this is wow. So the whole passage of not just verse 1, but the whole passage of Psalm 46 goes like this. God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her, and she will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar, kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice, the earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see what the Lord has done, the desolations he's brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire. He says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. And I just thought that that Psalm 46, verse 1, which we're familiar with, God is our refuge and strength, was so appropriate because I talked a lot about things happening, earthly, natural disasters and earthly things happening. And also that God is in charge. And of course, our next favorite verse with the verse 10, Psalm 46, 10, be still and know that I am God. And that's my daughter's confirmation verse. I'm sure that verse means a lot to many of you, but it's so hard for us to be still and know that He is God. It takes a lot of faith, and we ask the Holy Spirit to give us that faith and to help us to be still and know that He is God, because we tend to worry and plan, and our plans fail lately. With everything going on, and in our sinful nature, we just want to trust in man or in ourselves. And we're looking for leadership and guidance in the nation and in our state. And it's very, very hard for our leaders. It's very, very hard. So we continue to pray for our leaders. But we know that God is the ultimate leader, and He will care for us and protect us and keep us safe. And so that's our thought for today, is Psalm 46, the entire passage. Make sure you look that up, the number of verses it is. It's only, I think it's like 11, yeah, 11 verses, but they are very wonderful, comforting, and powerful verses for us. And so I see Gary's, thanks Heather, Gary's logged in, and Gary, just for you, we're going to do, for the fourth time, we're going to do, I'm but a stranger here. I'm kidding. he was the one that reminded me that I've kind of done it a lot. So I'm glad I got people keeping track, because I don't always. But we are going to do Thy Word is a Lamp. And we'll start with that. And then we'll end with Rock of Ages Cleft for Me. And hi, Colleen. Hey, Chris, my brother's on. So we're gonna try to turn this up a little bit, and hopefully you'll hear more of the notes than the keyboard itself. Still working on the technology part. And nobody in the last week, nobody sent me any. My brother just wrote howdy. He lives in Texas. Howdy. Nobody sent me any song requests, which I was really surprised about. Hi, Colleen. I was really surprised because a lot of people have favorite songs, and we have a newsletter coming out this month again. We had stopped it for a few months during all the craziness and with no new events to announce. But we have the newsletter coming out, and I wrote in there, if you have any song requests, hymns or contemporary songs, just to email it to me at music@stmartinbertrand.org, and we'll try to play them either here on the live stream or in church. So you get to hear your favorite comforting songs that you love to sing. Okay, I've got, I don't want to go too low here, do my transposing. And over here. There we go. That's too low. Okay, this one is Thy Word is a Lamp unto My Feet and a Light unto My Path. And it's in our hymnal. It's kind of an older song that at one point in time was contemporary. If any of you used to listen to Amy Grant, it's kind of it's turned into a hymn in our hymn book. Hey, Marcia, how you doing? Oh, and Marcia's in the... Marsha, my friend from Holy Cross Saginaw, she's on here right now, and she was in that that flooded area that most of you saw from the helicopter photos online. So how's that going, Marsha? Hopefully, I know you're back in your house, and I don't think you got any water, even though your whole entire neighborhood was pretty much a lake over in Shields there. Glad to see you're on and well. And so here we go. Thank you. that so you can sing it with me. Thy Word song, and I've got one more here. We'll do that at the end, I think. There we go again. I need a technology person in my house. Okay. It fell. And Marcia said, "We are dry." Praise the Lord, Marcia. And Heather said, "Love this song." I do too, Heather. It's so amazing. Because really, we don't turn to God's Word enough, and we should. And he comforts us and forgives us and heals us and takes care of us even when we don't turn to his word. But if we do, we find more peace. And every time I read something from God's word, I'm like, I should read this more often. This is really good and really helpful. And the more you read God's word, the more you think, I'm not reading God's word enough. I need to read God's word more. So that's kind of a good thing because it motivates you to keep reading his word and keep in touch with the Lord. So this next song is Rock of Ages. And I don't know right now, before we're going to pray and then do the song, and then I'll let everybody go. I don't want to go too long again like I did last Friday. So does anyone have any prayer requests that they want to put on to the live stream just to have me pray about over the live stream right now? If you do, just type those in and I'll get my page situated. But I really do hope everyone is doing well. And as far as the Michigan people who are online with me right now, I have no additional news for when church is starting, but I'm sure we will soon, because I do see that the governor is starting to loosen the restrictions on commercial businesses and the economy and such. So we should have openings very soon. And I know I've heard that churches also in our area are opening in different ways and in different formats. So just as quickly as this came upon us, I'm sure we will be back in no time, and we'll think, wow, that went quick, even though it didn't while we were in it. Okay, I don't see any prayer requests, so just if you want to just speak those on your own while we're praying. Then we'll pray a little prayer here, and then we'll pray the Lord's Prayer. Oh, and Gary's got one. He was typing. People affected by the flooding and best wishes for Marcia and her family. Yeah, Marcia's family, they were like right on that flooded road. It was crazy. So yes, thank God that she's tuned in here, and we know she said we are dry. So that's awesome. We got to pray for everyone in Midland and all over that is just, I know they did evacuated 10,000 people, I think, in like 24 hours. So it was pretty amazing what they did to get everyone evacuated. But now we're waiting for the waters to recede. So don't forget Psalm 46. That's what we read when we first logged on. And that was a really good psalm for the times we're in right now. Okay, let's pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for bringing us here today, and I ask your blessing on all your children and all in the world, Lord, who are suffering right now, those who know you and those who don't know you. We just ask that you Keep everyone safe and protected and wrapped in your love and care, Lord. And we just ask that we ask a special blessing on those who were evacuated with the flooding or whose properties and homes were destroyed. And we just ask your blessing on them and providing helpers and healing for them as they try to get back to their homes once these waters recede. We just ask that you are with us and that you help us to be your light in these times so that we can shine the light of Jesus to others. We just thank you and praise you for all that you give us, all the blessings we have now in the midst of all these world troubles, and that you still are a good God, a faithful God, a loving God, and you love us and you keep us safe, and you want the best for us. And so help us as we are enduring various forms of suffering. Help us to reach out to others who are also suffering. We thank you so much for sending Jesus into our lives to save us from our sin and to give us forgiveness of sins and eternal life with you, Lord. And we just ask that you send your Holy Spirit into our hearts and lives and our minds to calm us and bring us the true faith in you, Lord, so that we can carry on and always rest in you, Lord. And we ask that you forgive us when we fail. Every day we fail you, Lord, and every day you pick us back up again, and we are thankful for that. And we pray together now the prayer you have taught us, Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And love to have those of you that are with us tune in on Sunday for worship. Check online for all the kids' bulletins and the regular bulletin. Don't check online yet for that regular one. I gotta get that from Lori, and we'll get that up today, but it will be up. I think Wednesday's is still online, but we'll get that updated. And we just love having all of you here with us today. And so let's do Rock of Ages, and then we'll close out so we're not, again, too long like we were last week. Okay, here we go. I might have to lower that one. Okay. Gotta lower it for the altos. Okay, this is Rock of Ages, cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from thy riven side, which flowed, be of sin, the double cure. Cleanse me from its guilt and power. Of my hands can fulfill the law, thy law's demands. Not the labors of my hands can fulfill thy law's demands. Could my zeal no respite know? Could my tears forever flow? All for sin could Savior, or die, while I I think I really do need to nominate Gary as my song tracker. I think I did that one before too, but it's such a good one. There's so many good ones. I really can't be all to blame because I got no song requests from all of you in an entire week. So get those song requests to me, hymns, contemporary songs, and we'll try to get them on for the live worship Sundays and Wednesdays or an online devotion on a Friday when we do our singing. So hi Sue, hi Jenny. Hey Emma, how you doing? We're just getting ready to get off the live stream, but we're reminding everyone to tune in 9 a.m. this Sunday and to keep safe and to as best you are stay safe at home. But also, as the governor relaxes the requirements, that we get out in a little bit and help those that we can help in these times of need. Okay, so send in your song requests on Gary, track my songs so we don't do any repeats. Okay, everyone stay safe. And again, oh yeah, thanks, Jenny. And just feel free to get in touch with me or with the church or pastor. My email for those song requests is music@stmartinbirchrun.org, or you can put them right here in the comments. And give me your favorite song. All right, take care. Love you guys. We'll see you soon. I'm hoping it'll be soon here. Take care and God bless you this weekend. Bye.